My brother Jeff says that new camshaft to give me a higher valve lift.
My brother Jeff. That's all you ever talk about.
I guess he ought to know. He was a flyer in the Navy.
Yeah, so you've been telling me. Hey, if I were you, I'd take some weight off that flywheel. And you'll get more pickup if you put in a truck clutch like I got in my old meat grinder.
Yeah, I know. Try to find a truck clutch.
What a pity. I ditched my old one this morning. Mother put it in the Goodwill bag.
Hiya, Rusty.
Hiya, fellas.
Hello, Mickey.
Hiya, Peggy. Sit down, girls.
Oh, I can hardly wait. Hey, you guys, get the new dress. That's why we came over, so we could show it off. You like it?
Huh. It gives me the whammies.
Mickey, when are you going to put this hop up together and burn a little rubber, hmm?
It should be ready now, but it's so hard to get parts. Know something? My father's getting his new car today.
What?
No kidding.
Gee.
Yeah, I ordered it 2 years ago. Boy, where do you see her? She's a dilly.
Shaking your head. Do something, will you? Well, do something!
There's nothing I can do for her now.
You never even slowed up when you hit that turn. You skidded over 100 feet.
Then why wasn't I killed? Why do I have to go on living?
You'll have to figure that one out for yourself.
Officer. I saw that driver make the turn. You were right. Doing close to 60. If you want to take my name, I'll be willing to appear as a witness.
Won't be necessary for anyone to appear against him.
But he killed that child for the sake of other children.
I know. She was in the car with him. That was his own little girl that he killed. Move on, please. All right, folks, get going.
Holy cow! Oh, Jiminy Christmas!
Daddy, that's
John, it's simply divine. Oh, she's a tootsie.
Wait till you're riding her, honey. She doesn't roll, she floats. Oh,
jeepers, oh. Look at that dad.
Oh, boy, it's groovy.
You like it, girls?
Tip keen. Doesn't she send you, Jeff?
It sure does.
How about it, Jeff?
What a swell job, Ed.
Well, get in there behind that wheel. You may not believe it, but this car steers herself.
The dash is full of gimmicks, Jeff.
Oh, she's got everything. Temperature control. You can have it hot or cold.
Oh, I wish we could live in it.
Hey, look at that speedometer. She can do 120 miles an hour.
Not while we own it.
I should say not. You know, I saw something on the road today I'll never forget. A man was responsible for the death of his own child. Look on his face. You kids should have been there and might have taught you a lesson.
We don't drive fast, Dad.
Not very fast. Oh, I don't mind you having a car with a little power under the hood. I don't mind you letting her out on back roads, but I want you to be careful. Have you ever taken part in one of those drag races we hear about?
Drag races?
No, sir. Well, make sure that you don't. That's one thing I won't stand for.
Okay, Dad.
Oh, a drag race never hurt anybody.
What's the use in hopping up a car if you can't ever give her the gun?
Oh, he was just talking. Of course he was. Parents are so unsophisticated.
John, you warned Mickey about driving fast, and yet it was you who encouraged him to build that hot rod car.
Well, the kid has initiative, mechanical ability. I'd hate to smother it. Now, don't worry. I'll teach him how to drive carefully. Look, how would you like to try her out? A little trip up to Mountain Lake and back.
I'd love it.
Not bad, eh, Jeff?
She's all right.
See how she answers the wheel?
We'd be out of luck if she didn't. Do you have to pass every car on the road?
He's not passing every car, Mom. Just a few of them.
Honey, I've told you time after time it's impossible for anybody to drive with a supervisor in the back seat.
I'm not trying to supervise your driving. And for goodness sake, don't look at me, but look where you're going.
Forget I've been doing this for 25 years. You think I'm going too fast, Jeff?
I'm used to flying.
Flying. Wouldn't it be wonderful if I could just reach out and touch a button here on the dash and we'd take off in the air?
You don't watch yourself in these curves. That's just what we'll be doing.
Push the button, Daddy.
Driving is merely a matter of intuitive coordination between the brain and the... go wrong. Just what were you trying to do? Run us into the ditch?
I run you into your mind?
You saw me signal to get back in line and you tried to prevent it.
I didn't do anything of the kind.
If you'd shown a little consideration, a little common courtesy, this thing would never have happened.
You're a fine one to talk about courtesy. Cutting in from the right is a dangerous, contemptible trick. And only a road hog would resort to it.
Oh, so now I'm a road hog.
Dad, what's the use?
You're the kind of a guy who can't stand another driver passing.
Don't hit him, Daddy. Don't hit him.
You do anything to prevent it, even to wrecking a car.
What difference does it make? Who's to blame?
It makes a lot of difference.
Can't we settle this thing without a brawl?
I think I can. I've been following you for the past 3 miles.
Me?
It ought to give you rope enough to hang yourself in. Brother, you're hanging high. Half the time, you're hitting around 60.
Oh, that's impossible. I wouldn't drive that fast in a brand new car. I just got her today, and look what this fella did to her. Look at that fender.
I also have a crumpled fender.
You also have a crumpled fender. But what difference does it make on an old tub like that?
Let me see your license.
Well, I don't mind getting a ticket if this dope gets one, too.
Suppose you tell that to the judge.
I certainly will tell that to the judge. I'll tell that judge plenty.
You've heard what this officer had to say about you. How do you plead?
Why,
is it true or isn't it true?
You were there, Judge.
Yes, I was there. Just a dope, driving an old tub.
I had no intention of breaking the law. Perhaps I did exceed the speed limit, though it was only for an instant. As for passing on the right, well, dozens of other people were doing the same thing. It's a common practice.
Unfortunately, it is. A little consideration, a little common courtesy from one driver to another would prevent most of the accidents that happen on our highways.
Yes, sir. Your Honor, this is the first time that I've received a summons in 25 years of driving.
And this is one time too many. Mr. Clark, you're the kind of man who should never be seen in a traffic court. It sets a bad example to those who don't know any better. Those greedy drivers whose creed seems to be me first and the devil with the other guy. I didn't bring you here to punish you. In order to do that, I'd have to disqualify myself and let another judge sit in my place. Even then, I would have suggested a suspended sentence.
You mean that
I mean it's never too late to learn, I hope. You may go.
Oh, yes, sir. Thank you, Your Honor.
That's all right, Mr. Clark. That's quite all right.
Close thing, Pop.
He barely missed you.
So help me, if we didn't have laws, I believe the people of this country would deliberately kill each other on the street. That guy's a potential murderer. He ought to have his license taken away from him.
Yes, yes, but what happened in court?
Did they throw the book at you?
How much did they soak you?
Not a red cent. Do you know who the judge was? Tanner, the fellow who ran into him.
Daddy, we ran into him.
The judge was the fellow who was driving the other car?
That's right.
And he let you go?
Well, what else could he do? He knew I wasn't to blame. But I saw the insurance man and told him not to make any trouble.
That was very nice of you. Who was the girl with the judge?
That was the judge's daughter.
You didn't catch her first name.
No, no, I did. Oh, wait a minute, yes. Her name is Sue. Why?
Oh, just curious, that's all.
Come on, man, I'm hungry. Put the car away, will you, Mickey?
Okay, Pop.
What's eating you?
I thought I'd seen that dame before.
Miss Tanner?
Sure. She and her old man, the country club.
Funny Dad didn't recognize him.
Oh, Dad gave up his golf while you were away. He and Mom just use the club for dinner sometimes. Susie's not a bad dish, but personally, I like more meat on mine.
Where do you pick up that kind of talk?
Hey, look, am I a child? I know you got a jolt out of Susie. I'll fix it for you.
You'll mind your own business.
I know just what you're going through. I've been through it myself.
Again.
Why are you following me around? Aren't you a little young for that sort of thing?
Oh, I'm not following you around for myself. I'm following you around for somebody else. Oh, don't you remember me?
I believe I've seen you somewhere before.
I'm Mickey Clark.
Clark?
My old man and your old man kissed Linda's a couple of weeks ago.
Oh.
My brother Jeff was there, too. There's a great guy. Got everything. I'd like to introduce you.
No, thank you.
Did I hurt you?
Your head hit me right in the stomach.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry.
Miss Tanner, meet my brother, Jeff.
I'm glad to know you.
Well, I'm not glad to know you.
Well, that deal's made.
I don't know what to say.
Do me a favor. Don't say anything.
Listen. What you feel is a temporary paralysis of the nervous plexus here. The way to treat that is to loosen up the muscles.
Keep your hands to yourself.
Well, I'm only trying to help.
Thank you. You're very kind.
She's a sore little tomato.
She's a mad she could spit ink. We saw you showing off for that girl.
I was just fixing it for Jeff.
Well, you didn't fix it very good. She's bawling him out.
Jeff's sure getting his gear stripped.
Listen, after all he's been through, he knows how to handle dames.
Does he, Mickey? Is he masterful with them?
Are you kidding? I could tell you some tales that would curl your hair.
That's right. Give your big brother a build-up. Can't you see these two are getting the bang out of him? Go on, create a Frankenstein so he can turn on us and beat our time.
I know my father was to blame for what happened, and I apologize for the things he said to your father. He'd apologize himself, but you know he doesn't even think he was wrong. Like a lot of other people, he seems to change when he gets behind the wheel of a car. But honestly, he's a swell guy when you know him.
I don't think I want to know.
Am I going to have trouble with you?
I'm very glad I met you, Mr. Clark.
Well, that's something.
But my opinion of your father is unchanged. He drives like a hoodlum, and he ought to be in jail.
Is that the girl that we...
Yep, Judy, that's the girl.
Pretty, isn't she?
She's pretty, but she carries a pistol.
Carries a pistol? Where?
Fine business. We bring you girls over here to swim, and all you do is sit around and bug your eyes at Mickey's brother.
Now listen, don't you sizzle at me.
Well, holy cat, don't you realize it? Hey, Mickey, just how old is Jeff?
24.
There, you see? What do you want to be, an old man's darling?
Hey, Jeff, what's the matter? Didn't it take?
Not so good, Mickey.
Hi, Todd.
Well, how are you, girls?
Well,
super.
Say, I've been wondering, what's the setup in this quartet anyway? Who do you roll your socks for, Peggy?
Todd? No, she's Mickey's headache. I've got an option on Rusty, so I've been led to believe.
We've been hearing a lot about you, Jeff. All for the good. I'm P.N. about Flyer.
P.N.?
Psychoneurotic. It's a complex. Do you mind?
Oh, of course not.
What'd I tell you?
You're so strong.
Come on, I'll take you guys to lunch.
Oh, that'd be lovely.
I like that.
Smart fella. Okay, maybe a little food will straighten out their complexes.
You certainly are persistent, aren't you?
They taught me that in the Navy.
Oh?
If you miss your target the first time, come right back and make another run. Oh, by the way, I really appreciate you breaking those dates tonight.
And what makes you think I broke any dates tonight?
Four guys at the club quit talking to me.
I'm sorry I was so rude at the pool.
Oh, I've forgiven you for that.
Please, keep both hands on the wheel.
Missed the target again.
Your train leaves at 8:30, Nan.
Yes, I know. Mickey went to get my overnight case.
Always forgetting something.
Oh, goodbye, Mom. I'm sorry I can't come to the station.
It's all right, dear.
Here he comes. Hurry, Mickey.
I found it, Mom. You left it in the dressing
room. Thank you, dear.
Give our love to Grandma, and don't stay longer than a week.
You be a good boy and don't worry your father.
Mom's a great guy.
Darn good looking, too.
I'll say.
John, you will keep an eye on Mickey, won't you?
Of course. Don't I always?
Yes, but now that his hot rod car's finished, I'm afraid that
Now, I rode with him a couple of times, and I gave him some lessons in safe driving.
Oh, you did?
The kid did a great job on that car. A powerful little devil.
Yes, he is.
Don't worry, he can handle it. And he knows how I feel about racing. Mickey'll be all right.
I hope so.
Jupiter Pluvius, there it goes again. What happened to you, Mickey?
We thought you were lost or something.
Ah, this carburetor's acting up. Maybe it's a fuel pump. I don't know. I'm not getting enough gas.
What you really need is a little sap, and I don't mean in your carburetor.
Huh?
She's right, Mickey. You used to be on the ball all the time, and now you drive like an old fogey. She means an old fogey with whiskers.
How do you like that? Just because I promised my old man I wouldn't go loopy when I drive, you two dames think I've lost my nerve.
Gee, Mickey, you'd make such a swell showing in the drag race tomorrow.
But you had to go and turn it down because you promised Papa. I'll bet your brother Jeff never quibbled when he faced a dangerous situation in the war. I'll bet he didn't either. He's a man with courage and sand and guts and everything. He's the kind of a guy who would drive straight through to his objective.
What'd I tell you? You created a Frankenstein.
Oh, have I?
Shove over, Peggy.
Tell you whether I've got sand or not. I'm gonna give you a ride that'll shake you loose from your girdle. The whole idea is to get more compression, more gas in the cylinder, more engine RPMs.
Look at this tire, 650 rubber. Really gives you the old dig when you need it.
I got the guy to grind my cans. You know how much he soaked me? $90. Now he's got a mortgage on my egg beater.
Jeepers, if I only had a hand injector.
Listen, dope, you couldn't pump life into this old mill with a pull motor.
What's the matter? Want a catch, Todd?
Well, I don't know. It seems to be busted.
Hey, who brought these chicks here?
Didn't we tell you guys not to broadcast this race?
Scenery like this on the sidelines draws a crowd, and the crowd draws the cops.
Stop singing the blue smoke. These kids know the score.
We're mascot smoking. Todd brought me for luck.
There's no luck in a whistle bait.
Hey, you're talking about my lady friend.
Ignore it, Todd. Listen, Drip, you come under the heading of nuisance. Fix my necklace before I lose it.
It isn't your necklace we'll notice, my pet.
Wait a minute.
So help me out, flatten that guy like a rug.
Blow low on that nose. Smoke's got steam.
Yeah? So I turn him off.
What do you want? High blood pressure?
Listen, fellas. We got some new drivers in this bunch. So the first race will be a free-for-all to see how they shape up.
Those that know their stuff will qualify as entries in a timing race on the desert a week from Sunday.
That'll be legal. Okay, guys. The starting line is at the end of this road. Start from a dead stop and drag through all the gears. Now, come on. Let's get out of here.
Thank you.
this is the only one you caught?
Yes, Judge. I haven't booked him yet. Following your instructions about drag racers, I brought him straight to you.
Who were the other contestants in that race? Look, son, you're not under arrest. All I want from you is the names of the other boys. And I promise you they won't be arrested either. Now, how about it? So you won't talk, eh? I know you hate to snitch on your pals, and I don't blame you. But you can save them all a lot of trouble. If I convince you of that, will you help me out?
Yes, sir.
I thought you would. Sit down. Good morning, Mr. Clark.
The parents of these boys have appointed me their spokesman.
Yes, Mr. Clark.
My attorney's on his way here now, but in the meantime, I'd like to ask you a question.
Very well.
Why have you dragged us into court? Couldn't you have fined these boys without bringing us here?
I'll tell you why I brought you here. All of you. There was a time when a man could legally possess a gun. He abused that privilege and it became a crime. So it will be with hot rod cars.
But, Your Honor...
Your boys have become a menace on our country roads and city streets. And you, as their parents, are directly responsible. From now on, I'm going to place the blame squarely where it belongs. For every hot rod violation, I'm going to summon the parents of the offender and give them all the law allows. Last year, auto accidents killed 37,000 people in this country. This city is going to stop contributing to national mass murder. I want you boys to understand that this case is not closed. I'm releasing you in the custody of your parents. Until I decide what further steps to take. That's all.
Shouldn't have broken your word, Mickey.
I know, Dad, and I'm sorry. I'll never race it again.
We've got to make sure of that. We'll have to get rid of it.
Oh, Dad.
Your mother'll be home in the morning. She'll have to be told.
Why?
It'll be in the papers, won't it? She wouldn't let you keep it after what happened.
Jiminy, how would you like to have somebody make you get rid of your car?
I wouldn't like it at all. You've got a friend, haven't you?
A friend?
Todd.
Oh, sure.
Didn't you tell me his folks were out of town? That he'll be clear on the court thing?
Huh?
Well, you could leave it at his place, couldn't you?
Oh, sure.
But get it away from here before your mother comes home.
I got some work to do on it. I'll take it over to his place first thing in the morning.
I'll see that you do. By the way, you and Jeff will have to meet your mother's train. I've got an early appointment.
Okay, Dad. And gee, thanks a million.
It's all right, son. Just remember, no more racing.
I'll remember, Dad. Is that the right kind?
Sure is.
Holy mackerel, Jeff.
Yeah.
Do you know what time it is? We're going to be late for Mom's train.
Listen, I'm sorry, Mickey, but you'll have to go to the station alone. The office called and they need me right away.
Okay.
Hi, Ty.
Hi, Jeff.
Hop in. You can drop me off at the bus corner.
Be careful, kid.
Okay, Jeff.
Now, stop sign.
Did that stop sign say stop?
Oh, there's a cop on your tail.
We stop to let him write a ticket, we'll be 20 minutes late.
Oh, look, that's your mother's train.
It sure is her train.
You can't lose that cop now. You've got to stop.
That's what you think.
Suppose he got our number?
Would have if it hadn't been for that train.
Boy, that was sharp.
Hey, do you know what I heard? That place is full all the time. They haven't got half room enough. Hey, what's the matter?
We won't say anything about what happened this morning. Get me?
Yeah.
That's supposed to be?
You?
Well, I know it doesn't stick up like that.
Well, it sticks up.
This is our night. The moon, the sea, stars.
Yeah, I can see the Big Dipper.
You drip. Why do I love you?
I'm that kind of a character.
Listen, Square, do I mean anything to you?
Well, sure you do, Rusty.
Oh, then wipe that smirk off your pan.
You wipe it off.
Oh, you're about as romantic as a sardine. That tune churns me, Mickey.
Why, you're crying. What's the matter, Plumcake?
Oh, I don't know. Life. It's all so complicated. I've got a neurosis.
Too many hamburgers.
It's my nerves. I've been jittery ever since exams.
Just because you flunked your finals?
You don't know how they razz me at home. Am I a failure, Mickey? Do I look like a victim of arrested development?
Holy cat, no. You're perfect. Come on, give.
All right, break it up, kids. Put the smooching.
No matter where you go when you don't need one, there's always a cop.
They've all got holes in their heads.
What happened to our constitutional rights?
Hey, it's after 11. We better shove off.
I told my folks I'm going to stay with Peggy tonight. But I told my mother I was going to sleep at your house. You did? Yes, and it'll be awfully late when we get home. Oh, well, there's always the gag of the flat tire. Uh-uh. Mom won't eat that one anymore.
Oh, you kids will dream up something.
This is station KGI. 11:15... And time for the news. And a good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Police have recovered the body of a hot rod driver whose car plunged into the ocean tonight.
Hey.
The car, described as a stripped-down green roadster, is under 40 feet of water. The body of the youthful driver, so far unidentified, is lying in the county morgue.
A green roadster. Could be Eddie Swain.
Well, Eddie's up at Bass Lake on a camping trip. He's been gone 2 weeks.
There aren't many green paint jobs in the bunch we know.
We'll find out. Let's get going.
Here's the morgue, remember, Mickey?
Yeah. We passed it the other day.
Hey, this is where they got that hot rod guy. Hey, what do you say we go in and ask him if they found out who he is?
I won't go in that place.
But it might be somebody we know.
There wouldn't be anyone there at this hour.
There'd have to be a night watchman.
Wait a minute, I'll find out. I rang the night bell, but there's no answer.
Let's try the alley entrance.
Sure, we can't leave the cars here.
I won't go in that place.
So you stay in the car, honey. Look at Rusty, you can't face her.
I go where Todd goes.
Atta, baby.
The way in. Come.
I won't stay here either.
Why not?
I'm afraid.
You're afraid to go with us and you're afraid to stay here. Will you make your mind?
I can't.
Come on.
Come on,
why are you going to tell her that?
Shh. It's unlocked.
Hey, what's that noise?
I don't know, unless it's my heart.
From the cafe across the street.
That noise didn't stop. I'll scream.
If you do, I'll crown you.
Hey!
Or Mickey will. The only reason you're scared is because... it's because you're not thinking straight. This is the place where the chumps end up. They ask for it. A lot of other people don't ask for it. Get it just the same.
That's the scales where they weigh them when they bring them in.
Weigh what?
I heard that's the first thing they do. Weigh them.
Why?
Oh, must we go into detail? No.
I wonder where they put that guy. Your eyes smart.
That noise, if it doesn't stop.
Look.
That's what it is. Nothing but water dripping from a faucet.
See, no matter what happens, there's always an explanation. We came here to find out something, didn't we? Well, I'm going through with it. There's only one place they'd have that kid. That's in there.
If you go in there, you go alone.
All right?
No, Mickey.
Bet you haven't got nerve enough for that.
Thank you. It's Bob Cooper. The red-headed guy that lives in the country. Yeah.
I remember he does have a green poacher.
Hey! Hey! What's the matter? Peggy! Don't do that! Peggy! Holy cat, she's out! But can't you see if we do that, we'll all get pinched for burglary?
Well, gee, we gotta do something. What the heck? We had good reason for going to the morgue. Let's go back.
Cops! They never believe us. We'll pinch them and then we'll go back.
I hardly saw anything. All I know is there was nothing there. And then there was a car and I socked into the rear end of it. If only the guy had made the turn, if he hadn't stopped short like that.
He must have been scared to death.
Now look, if there's any trouble, I won't let Todd take the rap. I promise you, I'll park my car someplace. And the minute I get home, I'll phone up his house and find out what happened. Don't you worry.
But what about Rusty?
Holy cat, I forgot about her. Ah, but that kid's sharp. She'll find some way to get out of that place.
She could climb out one of the windows.
Sure, sure. That'd be no trick for Rusty. She won't say anything, and you keep your trap shut, too. Good night, honey.
Good night, Nicky.
I'll call you tomorrow.
Yes.
Bet you anything you like, Rusty's home in bed right now.
Thank you. Hey, Dad. Oh, well. Hello.
Where are you going?
I was just taking Sue home.
We saw you and we stopped to say hello. But, Mr. Clark, it's so late.
Oh, what of it? Come on in anyway. I've got something to tell you.
Good news?
Well, not bad.
We'll wake everybody up.
Oh, no, we won't.
Oh, Mrs. Clark, think.
She'll think it's all right. I'll guarantee that. Where have you been?
Well, we had dinner at the beach and took a drive along the ocean front. Say, I had no idea you were going out.
I spent the evening with Judge Tanner.
With my father?
Oh, what a guy. Wait till I see how the family is and I'll tell you all about it. Jeff, see what's in the refrigerator, will you?
This way.
I feel like an intruder without your mother knowing.
Oh, don't be silly. Mom would love it.
Well, everybody's asleep. Judy's curled up like a kitten, and Mickey's... Yeah, I wonder if that devil is asleep.
It's funny he didn't stick around for a snack.
Yes, it is funny. But you never know about that guy. Anyway, he is in, and that's what counts.
It's another worry off his mother's mind.
You know, Sue, I spent a very interesting evening with your father.
Well, how did you two get together?
I called him up and made an appointment. We met at your house.
Oh?
I should have done it long ago. But sometimes it's difficult to admit you're in the wrong. Anyhow, now we're friends.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Didn't I tell you he was a good guy?
You were right, Jeff.
Well, that's swell news, Dad. You know, you've sort of broken the ice for me. I gotta see the judge myself and have a talk about Sue.
You mean that... that you two are going to... You mean it's a deal?
Uh-huh.
Oh, well, what do you know about that? Wait till your mother hears this.
Do you think she'll approve of it?
Approve? She thinks you're the sweetest thing that ever happened to us. You lucky devil. Well, happy days. Excuse me. I'll be back in a minute. Happy... Hello? Speaking. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'll be there.
We interrupt this program to bring you Howard Emerson with a late roundup of news.
During this weekend, from Friday until midnight, 10 people died and 39 were injured in traffic accidents on the streets and highways of this city. A family of four were wiped out late tonight when the driver of their car tried to beat a train to the grade crossing at Riverside. And a report has just come to the studio of a fatal crash that occurred at the corner of Central and Pine. A hit-and-run killer left two broken bodies lying in the wreckage of two cars. One of them is that of an unidentified youngster who was driving a cut-down racer.
Todd!
The other victim of the crash was... Just a second, please. Oh, yes, the driver of an Iroquois sedan, Mrs. John Clark, wife of the prominent real estate broker.
Mrs. John Clark, 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 Mrs. John Clark.
with the gun. Mom? Mom, I gotta see you. Mom, what do you think there?
Oh, no, no, no.
Mickey. Mickey, your father and Jeff have gone to the Mercy Hospital. They asked me to come back. Jeff remembered that we left the radio on and was afraid that you might...
That wasn't my mom, Miss Tanner. I know that. I know it. They said she was driving an Iroquois sedan. We haven't got an Iroquois sedan. Where would she be going anyway? Why wouldn't I know about it?
Haven't you been at the beach all day?
Yes.
Your father drove your mother out to your uncle's house early this evening.
Uncle Jim?
I believe so.
And you knew she wasn't here?
Yes. Jeff told me at dinner. Your aunt was very ill.
Then she's still out there. I'll prove it to you. I'll call Uncle Jim's house and get Mom on the phone.
Mickey, wait. Mickey, the police told your father
that... What would she be doing out alone at that time of night? They're crazy, Miss Tanner. It was somebody else. A woman who looked like Mom. There are lots of Clarks in this town, hundreds of them in the phone book. Somebody's always calling my dad thinking he's somebody else. What did the police tell my father?
Simply that they'd found her.
Do they know who did it?
I don't think so.
Hello, Uncle Jim. This is Mickey. Will you let... I want to talk to my mother. You mean she? How? Get home. She knew I was out. It was worried.
Oh, Mickey.
Mercy Hospital.
Yes, dear.
I want to go there.
Don't you think you'd better wait until your father calls?
I want to go there.
All right, dear. I'll go with you.
Find out.
I heard on the radio. Mom's gonna be all right. Isn't she?
I hope so. Her head was badly injured, but...
Not her face, Jeff.
Oh, no. Well, she's still under the anesthetic, and we'll know more by morning. The doctor says she has a good chance. Why don't you run along home?
You can't fool me, Jeff. I know better. I can tell. Mom's gone.
No, she isn't gone. Now, come on, Mickey. You can't go to pieces like a kid. Be a man.
That's what I'm trying to be, but I guess I don't know how. I gotta know the truth. You'll tell me, won't you, Dad?
Stop it, Mickey. Stop it. Don't you know where you are? Isn't it bad enough without your coming here and making a scene? We've got to get him out of here.
This next room is unoccupied.
Hmm?
Thank you.
Your mother's alive, son. The doctors have hopes of pulling her through, but that's all it is. Just a hope. She insisted on coming home tonight in your uncle's car because she wanted to be with us. And for that, she was nearly killed. Because two morons were racing in the streets. One of them died for it. The other one got away. And they'll get him. They'll get him.
Why was the other one dead? It was Todd Powell who was killed. We weren't racing. We were being chased by the police for something else. A car came out of a side street. We tried to go around it. My car hit the rear end. And I ran away. I didn't go back. I was afraid. I know you'll hate me. I don't blame you. I wish I was where Todd is. I wish you'd kill me.
You didn't go back. You ran away. You were afraid. I don't know what they'll do to you, and I don't know that I care. If your mother dies, I never want to see you again.
Dad. Dad.
You didn't mean that. I'm going to be sorry you said it. You'd better take it back.
Now look, Jeff.
You're one of the best fathers two boys ever had. Given us everything we've ever wanted. Bought us cars when you couldn't afford them. Taught us how to drive them. Told us all the things we shouldn't do. Told us over and over again. And then went out and did those things yourself. Mickey believes in you. You're a great guy to him. Who could be more right than his old man?
Mr. Clark?
I'm John Clark.
I'm from the sheriff's office. Have you a boy by the name of Michael?
Yes. Here he is.
We found out that he was responsible for that accident that happened tonight.
I know. He told me.
I'm sorry, I'll have to take him down and book him.
But he's only a kid. You can't.
I know. There's a kid over in that morgue, too.
What's the charge?
Suspicion of manslaughter.
But he's only 16. You can't book him in the county jail.
Oh, yes, we can, Mr. Clark. We have a lot of boys over there that age. Too many. Of course, you can put up a bond for his appearance.
Jeff, go with him. Don't leave him alone for a minute. See that he gets home. I'll look after him, Dad.
When the night watchman returned, you and your friends ran out of the morgue.
Yes, sir. It was in the dark and I went to the wrong door. I was locked in.
Why didn't you call the watchman? Tell him what happened.
I was afraid to. I didn't know what they'd do to me. I was waiting in the closet, but I heard them bringing Todd in.
Did you see him?
Those scales. I screamed then. They found me.
I suppose you know that you contributed to his death.
Oh, no, no.
Judge, I'm sorry, Mr. Davis. She must be told the truth. I know you were not with them at the time of the accident. I'm speaking of other occasions. Peggy Anders was here with her mother. And she admitted that you both rode with the boys, and they frequently drove through the streets at high speeds. That you girls never objected. That you encouraged them to do so. Did you know about that, Mr. Davis?
Well, you see, Judge, I'm a very busy man.
Too busy to be concerned about your daughter?
Of course not. Rusty's mother died when she was a baby. I've had the sole care of her.
Oh. I wonder how many fathers can answer these questions. Do you know who your girl was out with last night? where she went and what she did? Did you have the satisfaction of knowing whose car she came home in? Did you hear her key go in the front door? Or do you think she might have climbed in through a rear window? Did she come to you and kiss you goodnight? And did you know that she was safe? Think it over, Mr. Davis.
I shall.
As for you, Rusty, your experience has taught you more than I can. If more girls your age could see what you have seen, there would be very few of them brought to juvenile court.
Hi, Jeff.
Hello. Hello, fellas.
Hello, Mr. Clark. Jeff, couldn't you get him to call us as witnesses? We'd all take the stand.
We'd tell a judge that Mickey's a right guy.
We'd tell him anything that would help.
But there's not a thing you can do. In fact, there's nothing I can do.
We're worried about Mickey.
I know.
Tell him we're standing by.
Thanks, fellas.
Your Honor, my son is charged with being responsible for an accident that killed his best friend and seriously injured his mother. The doctors tell us that his mother will recover.
You should thank God for that.
Me too. It's said that we create our own hell here on Earth. My son and I know that to be true. Nothing I can say can excuse the crime he committed or bring back the boy who died. But I want it to be known that I'm equally guilty with my son. I set him the example. I gave him good advice. But like so many parents, I seldom practice what I preach. Why is it that the best of us become greedy, bullying beasts the instant we have the power of 100 horses in our hands? The power for good, for progress. Why do we use it to cause fright and unhappiness? To maim, to cripple, to kill.
Go on.
My son will see his mother today for the first time since the accident. She doesn't know that he was the cause of it. I don't know what she'll say when he tells her. I do know that she'll forgive him. She'll forgive us both.
Mr. Clark, I wish it were possible for you to share the legal responsibility of this charge, but the law takes no cognizance of the sins of the fathers. Your son has pleaded guilty, and he will have to bear the brunt of this alone. You might have thought of that when you signed his application for a license to drive. Young man, I want you to appear before me at 10 a.m. September 17th. At that time, I will pass sentence upon you.
Yes, sir.
Are you going to the hospital now? Does your mother know that you were here this morning? I wouldn't tell her that if I were you. You may go.
When your car came out of that side street, it was just as if it had dropped out of the sky. I tried to stop, but I couldn't. I was going too fast. I tried to go around it, but there wasn't room. I'll hear that crash all my life. I did it, Mom. I was to blame. Nobody else. My poor darling. Were you hurt?
Well, we'll have our boy back in about an hour.
Yes, he took it like a man. It'll be 3 hours at the speed you're going.
He won't mind waiting a little longer.
Must we stay in the middle of this snail's parade? Can't we get up front where we can breathe?
John, haven't I told you time and again that it's impossible for anybody to drive with a supervisor?
I'm not trying to supervise you, but I'm sick of looking at the rear end of that car ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Take it easy, honey. Take it.